You're watching Vinylic Puma Gaming. What's up, guys? So, a couple months back, I made a video discussing what I thought were some of the best guns and weapons for Fallout 4's survival mode. Now, you guys seemed to like that video, so I figured I would go ahead and make an update to that video and include some of the new awesome weapons that got added from Fallout 4's DLCs. Some of the new DLC weapons have made the others from the previous list completely obsolete, and I felt it was time for an update. Now, this video will be mostly spoiler-free, though I will be telling you that certain unique items exist. That said, I'm not going to be telling you how to get them so you can experience them for yourself. I'm also going to be grading these weapons based on their damage, ammo weight, and overall ammo efficiency. And ammo efficiency is simply how much damage you can deal with these weapons per pound of ammo fired. So, without further ado, these are going to be the top 9 best guns and weapons for survival mode, now including DLC. Number 9, the Gauss Rifle. Obviously, this is going to be a gun that's best used by stealth characters with the Rifleman perk. Now, the Gauss Rifle used to occupy the 6th spot on this list, however, it isn't quite as ammo efficient as some of the weapons from both the Far Harbor and Nuka World DLCs. Even still, the Gauss Rifle is phenomenal, considering the weapon's damage potential, it's relatively lightweight, however the 2mm electromagnetic cartridge ammo that it uses is very heavy. You can only carry about 8 bullets per pound, but you're dealing 110 to 192 damage before perks, bobbleheads, and without sneak attacks. Once you start adding all that stuff in, you may end up having something that's more ammo efficient than some of the other weapons on this list. Ultimately, it's going to really depend on your build. Number 8, the Deliverer. In the last video, the Deliverer was in the number 5 spot. Even at number 8, I still highly recommend the Deliverer, as it's a really good pistol both for stealth pistol users or anyone that has built their character around VATS. As you can imagine, since the Deliverer is a pistol, you're going to get the best use out of it with the Gunslinger perk. Now, 10mm ammo is still really good ammo that is actually on the lighter side, when you can usually carry about 25 to 35 bullets with all of the other weapon types. 10mm ammo is above average, as you can carry 40 bullets per pound. If you're going to use 10mm ammo at all, your best option is really only going to be the Deliverer, unless you have some kind of mods installed that allow you to use 10mm on like your combat rifle or something. Overall, this will be a great weapon for pistol users, especially for sneak builds. Number 7, Laser Pistols and Rifles. What's nice about most of the energy weapons in general is that they are very modular. You can have anything from a sniper, an automatic pistol, or just your standard laser rifle. What I will say is that you're going to be getting the best ammo efficiency and damage from the classic laser weapons. The Institute versions suck in my opinion, and you should skip them entirely. If you're using fusion cells, your other choices could be like the laser musket and the alien blaster pistol. The problem with the laser musket is that it's really good early on, but the laser pistol or rifle is actually better when you upgrade the capacitor. The alien blaster pistol doesn't gain enhanced damage at all and has projectiles that actually move slower, and it actually makes it a little bit harder to hit your targets. So you might actually miss more with the alien blaster pistol. There are plenty of unique variants of all of these. Instead of reading them off to you, I'll go ahead and list them in the upper right hand corner of the screen. I personally prefer either the Wazer Rifle or Prototype UP-77. Both of those have the never-ending legendary weapon effect, but depending on your build, you may ultimately end up choosing differently. Especially if you have a luck or VATS-based build, you might like the Righteous Authority. Number 6, the Western Revolver. So this got added with Nuka World, and for the most part is just a superior version of the 44 pistol from Fallout 4 Vanilla. With the standard 44 pistol, you're going to be getting about 84 damage per shot with the advanced receiver, while with the Western Revolver, you're going to be getting about 105 damage per shot with the same advanced receiver. I suppose it's also worth mentioning that you're maximizing the damage potential of the 44 caliber ammo as well with the Western Revolver. Now, there is a downside, and that is that there aren't any official unique variants of the Western Revolver. But I will say that you can occasionally get Western Revolvers with legendary effects to appear. And since most unique variants are regular weapons with legendary effects, I'd say you're actually better off trying your luck there as opposed to religiously using Kellogg's pistol or something like Eddie's piece. Number 5, the handmade rifle. Just like I mentioned with the Western Revolver and 44 pistol, the handmade rifle pretty much makes both the combat and assault rifles obsolete. You're getting better damage and identical ammo weight to the assault rifle, and in the case of the 308 combat rifle, which was actually my number 3 choice last time, you're getting better damage at a lower ammo weight. So you can actually feasibly carry more ammunition with you than you could with the 308 combat rifle. Plus, the handmade rifle is capable of a very high magazine size as well. I think the combat rifle tops out at about 40. The handmade rifle with the automatic magazine is like 75. That said, there are some problems. The first is the upgrade requirements are very high. You'll need Rifleman, Commando, and Big Leagues maxed out in order to enjoy all of the best upgrades. Another problem is that you'll need 7.62 ammo, which can only be looted either off of the gangs in Nuka World or purchased in Nuka World. And you may also find that the weapon itself is quite heavy as well. You're going to expect about 24 to 26 pounds when fully upgraded, which is pretty heavy for any gun. That said, the handmade rifle has excellent unique variants. I think you'll like both the Problem Solver and Splatter Cannon, as both have the Furious Legendary Weapon effect. And this is going to be great for commando builds. Number 4, the Radium Rifle. So while the handmade rifle makes the 308 combat rifle obsolete, the radium rifle makes the standard 45 combat rifle obsolete. The fully upgraded semi-automatic combat rifle deals about 49 damage per shot, compared to the fully upgraded radium rifle, which is dealing 60 damage per shot, and that doesn't even count the radiation damage. The automatic version of the radium rifle will also be vastly superior to the submachine gun, and I recommend that you swap your spray and pray for your kiloton radium rifle ASAP. Speaking of the Kiloton Radium Rifle, it's really good for Commando or Rifleman perk users. The explosive effect is useful for dismembering ghouls so they can't get close to you. If you choose the Kiloton Radium Rifle, you can boost its damage potential by maxing out either Rifleman or Commando, Demolition Expert perk, and Nuclear Physicist. And it's also worth mentioning that you can also boost your damage a teeny bit more with the Bloody Mess perk as well. Between the radium rifle and handmade rifles, you're not going to really need anything else, in my opinion. Number 3, plasma weapons. If you watched the original list, these were number 2, and I would say, even at number 3, plasma weapons are going to be your best choice for ammo efficiency for either gunslinger, commando, or rifleman perk users. That said, you're going to get the best damage from the sniper barrel versions, which can be used on pistols and rifles, but not on automatics. While I traditionally don't recommend you buy ammo, it might actually be a good idea to purchase plasma cartridges if you can get a good price on them. I'd say spend no more than one bottle cap over the in-game value per bullet. The biggest advantage plasma has is that it deals a combination of ballistic and energy damage, and with the right upgrades, you can deal a combined 120 damage per shot. You'll also notice that there is no charging requirement like you might see on the laser sniper rifle, though you will have a magazine size of only 12. I would say if you decide to use plasma weapons, see if you can get a legendary variant of this. Otherwise, both the Experiment 18-A and Sentinel's Plasma Caster are pretty good. Number 2, the Gatling Laser. So this previously had the number 1 spot. This is without a doubt one of the best and most ammo efficient guns or weapons in Fallout 4. Each fusion core can provide up to 500 shots, and while fusion cores are initially expensive, once you can get them for under 500 caps, you suddenly have ammo that's cheaper than either 5mm ammo or even 38 caliber ammo. Plus, with the right upgrades, you can get the Gatling laser to be superior to the laser rifle or pistol in terms of damage. Now, Nukeworld added a really cool unique Gatling laser called the Eternus. Thanks to its never-ending effect, it gets infinite ammo. However, you will find that the Eternus is terrible for VATS, so you may want to use either the Final Judgment or just a regular Gatling laser instead. Even still, infinite ammo would be a godsend for survival mode difficulty, where ammo is always weighing you down. Number 1. The Thirst Zapper. So I know this is sort of a joke gun, but the Thirst Zapper is actually really good, especially if you can get the weaponized quantum version of the Thirst Zapper. Not only are you almost getting the damage of the Fat Man, but you're getting it at much lower ammo and weapon weight. So keep in mind that your Fat Man is going to weigh about 30 pounds with like 12 pound bullets, while the Thirst Zapper weighs 2 or 3 pounds and you can carry 40 bullets in 1 pound. The downside is that it appears that the Thirst Zapper can only be boosted with the Demolition Expert perk and the Explosive Bobblehead. You would think something like Gunslinger or even the Bloody Mess perk would work, but it doesn't appear to at the time of making this video. Another thing is, like all other explosive weapon projectiles, you don't want to be next to it when it goes off. You may actually kill your character or seriously damage your power armor if you're too close. That said, 40 shots that are almost as powerful as a stock Fat Man under 3 to 4 pounds total is really impressive. I just wish it was more like a conventional gun. Alright guys, that's going to pretty much wrap up this particular video. If you like this video, please be sure to leave a like. You know, let's see if we can get to 800 likes. If we can, great. If we can't, no big deal. I'll be here, maybe not tomorrow, but in a day from now, because I still got some things going on with my life at the moment. So just bear with me. Again, take care, and I'll see y'all next time.